that is going to be nomenclature, means give the heading classification and nomenclature. Nomenclature of organic compounds. Okay, so this is the heading that we are going to start today. Organic chemistry in 9th, 10th, you don't have done much organic. So that's why I thought of starting this, and also it's easy. Okay, all of you, it's easy. Organic compounds, actually, if I just tell you, there are millions and millions of organic compounds around us. Since we get up early in the morning until the night, we are using, knowingly or unknowingly, we are using many organic compounds. Okay, starting from the day until going to the bed. Okay, all of you know the many names, but I'll just name few of them. Very important is petrol, diesel. Those are alkanes. LPG, on which the cooking is done. Those are alkanes. Alkane is a part of organic compound. Okay. After that, in fact, petroleum products are very important for our day-to-day use. Okay. Although we are going forward for the electrical vehicles, but still we are dependent on the petrol and diesel. For next 50 years, also we are going to get the electrical, all the electrical vehicles, all the vehicles getting converted to electrical. Then also we are not going to get free from the petroleum products. Remember it. It's very important, petroleum products. Petroleum is not going to be used as a petrol. Crude oil, it is basically a many applications are there of petroleum, means petrol actually, like paint ho gaya, it's a paint, it's a cosmetic industries, it's a your wooden, means it is going to be your the engine. So all are going to dependent on the petroleum products. So petrol is one of the very very important organic compound. You have got LPG. Next is sugar. All of you must be liking the sugar. Sugar is also there. It's organic compound. You can see all the grains that you take for your healthy body. It is organic compounds. You have a carbohydrates, you have a vitamin, you have enzymes, you have proteins. All are organic compounds. Okay. Then the clothes that you have, that is a organic compounds. Actually, it is a polyester, polyethylene, the polythene that we use. It is an organic compound. If you go with this now, let's say next part, if you just take the vegetables, means everything, means so till morning, since morning until night, we are surrounded by the organic compounds. Organic compound mainly what, which is where the carbon is the main component. That is the organic compound. So in this chapter, we are trying to classify them and we are trying to learn its naming. How do we name those organic compounds? Okay. So this is the first part of today's lecture that we'll be doing. So organic compound, the first organic compound which was synthesized in the laboratory, all of you must be knowing, it was the urea, which was synthesized in the laboratory. And urea, if I just tell you, the urea is CO, means it is NH2, CONH2. It is the structure of the, it is the molecular formula of the urea. Its structure is basically this. If I just draw here, this was the structure of this. It is a structure of urea. All of you must be aware of this, okay? I think, can you see the colors, blue, red? It is visible to all of you. So here we have got, this is the first organic compound which was synthesized in the laboratory. Okay. After this, so how to start this topic? So first of all, we have to get some basic idea of some elements, how it forms the bond, and its lone pair, how many lone pairs are there with that. So we have to first know about this. Okay. So the first part I'm going to do this here. Now just make a column here, all of you. And I expect all of you to make a proper notes, okay? You have to write in your textbook. I'm using this as a board. I will send it pic also, but you have to write in your notebook also. So make sure. So let's say I'm just taking here, we have a first column is element. Then you have, let's say, atomic number, then electronic configuration. Then you have got here, the fourth is number of bonds required and lone pair. देखो ये, कैन यू सी दिस ऑल ऑफ यू?
वो लास्ट क्या है?
लोन पेयर, इट इज लोन पेयर. यहाँ पे इन नाइन्थ और टेंथ और मे बी इन एट्थ यू मस्ट हैव डन दिस, ओके? 9th, 10th or maybe in 8th standard, you must have done this. Dekho, I have taken first element, which is important in organic compound. I am dealing with organic today. So I'll be taking first is carbon. Okay. So carbon, I hope atomic number, or let's say, carbon, the atomic number of the carbon, all of you must be knowing. It is 6. Okay, atomic number of the carbon is 6. Electronic configuration, anybody can tell me electronic configuration?
2, 4.
Yes, 2, 4. Again, you must have learned this, it is a second period element. Carbon is a second period element. Or second period element, they strictly follow octet rule. Octet rule is strictly followed there. So again, outermost shell, it needs 8 electrons. Outermost shell needs here, it needs 8 electrons. So look, here 2 hai, 4 hai. Outermost shell mein 8 electrons chahiye. So it needs 4 more electrons here. So it goes for the covalent bond. All of you must have heard the name covalent bond. Covalent bond means sharing of the electron. The bond formed because of sharing of the electron. So here, carbon needs 4 bonds to complete the octet. One bond is formed by the sharing of 1 electron each from the given atom. Okay. One bond forms by the sharing of 1 electron each. Okay. So number of bonds required is 4. And here there is no lone pair. Lone pair is 0 here for carbon. Then comes nitrogen. Just see nitrogen. These are going to be there in the organic chemistry. That's why I'm doing this. Nitrogen, the atomic number is 7. एटॉमिक नंबर इज 7. So its electronic configuration will be 2, 5. Outermost shell में 5 electron आ गए. Now how many electron it need to complete octet? Nitrogen 3 atoms. Okay, so nitrogen needs 3 electron to complete the octet. So it needs 3 bond. Because one bond is because of one electron from each atom. And yahan pe ek lone pair hota hai. What is lone pair? Just to let you know, again, these things will come again in the chemical bonding chapter in great detail. Lone pair means the outermost. The electron in the outermost shell, which is not participating into bond formation, that is lone pair. If you wish, you can write the electron in the outermost shell, which is not participating into bond formation. So electron in the outermost shell, which is not participating into bond formation. Okay. So, yahan pe ek lone pair means two electron. Pair means two. So, one lone pair means two electron. Then you have got oxygen. Oxygen, again, atomic number is 6. So electronic configuration, if you write it is 2, 4. Sorry, atomic number is 8. It is 2, 6. Oxygen, atomic number is 8. It is 2, 6. Number of, it requires 2 more electrons to complete the octet. So it's mein 2 bond. And number of lone pair is 2 here. Number of lone pair is 2 here. After oxygen, the next is fluorine. Fluorine atomic number is 9. 2, 7, it needs only one bond because it needs only one electron to complete the octet. And here the number of lone pair will be 3. In fluorine, you will have a 3 lone pair. And the last one, which will be very common in organic, will be hydrogen. Hydrogen atomic number is 1. Electronic configuration 1 only. And hydrogen is in first period. So in a first period, it needs only 2 electrons to complete the duet. Second period onwards, we need to complete octet. And in a first period, we need to have a duet. So it is going to have only one bond because it needs only one electron. So it requires only one bond. And no zero lone pair here also. देखो ये दिस इज वाई वी नीड दिस बिकॉज इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री वी आर गोइंग टू हैव कार्बन हाइड्रोजन विल बी वेरी कॉमन कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन विल बी वेरी कॉमन ओके एंड देन ऑक्सीजन नाइट्रोजन फ्लोरीन विल बी देयर. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल टेक फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स हियर. नाउ लेट्स से CH4 यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दिस. इट्स अ फर्स्ट मेंबर ऑफ द अल्केन फैमिली. इट इज मीथेन. तो CH4 द स्ट्रक्चर इज बेसिकली देखो कार्बन वी ड्रॉ लाइक दिस. कार्बन नीड्स फोर बॉन्ड. बॉन्ड को हम लोग इस लाइन से शो करते हैं हम लोग. दिस इज वन बॉन्ड वन बॉन्ड वन बॉन्ड वन बॉन्ड. तो वी शो बॉन्ड बाय अ लाइन. तो इसलिए कार्बन सो हियर हाइड्रोजन एच 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 एच. जस्ट सी व्हाट डज दिस मीन. इट्स मीनिंग इज जस्ट सी वन बॉन्ड फॉर्म्स बिकॉज ऑफ टू इलेक्ट्रॉन. वन इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम कार्बन वन फ्रॉम हाइड्रोजन. वन बॉन्ड फॉर्म्स बिकॉज ऑफ टू इलेक्ट्रॉन. वन फ्रॉम कार्बन वन फ्रॉम हाइड्रोजन. सेम हियर वन कार्बन वन हाइड्रोजन वन कार्बन वन हाइड्रोजन. इट इज लाइक दिस. सो जस्ट सी कार्बन का के 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हो गए बिकॉज दे आर शेयरिंग. तो इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑफ हाइड्रोजन इज ऑल्सो द इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑफ कार्बन. सो दिस इज सो नेक्स्ट टाइम ऑनवर्ड्स वी वॉन्ट बी शोइंग द डॉट. आई विल बी जस्ट शोइंग द स्ट्रेट लाइन. स्ट्रेट लाइन मीन्स वन बॉन्ड मीन्स टू इलेक्ट्रॉन. इट इज सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी. So carbon needs four bonds. So you can just see 1, 2, 3, four bonds are visible here. Hydrogen needs one bond. Just see, it needs one bond. So one bond. So for this hydrogen, one bond. For second hydrogen, second bond. For third, third, fourth, for fourth. So you have to arrange them in such a way that each carbon gets. Going to complete its four bonds. Each hydrogen is going to complete its one bond. Now let's say if we have next is CH3, CH3. The next compound is ethane, CH3, CH3. Or we also write like this, C2, H6. So so draw its bond structure. यहाँ पे देखो ऑर्गेनिक में हमेशा देयर विल बी कार्बन कार्बन के बीच बॉन्ड हमेशा होगा बिकॉज कार्बन हैज गॉट द प्रॉपर्टी कॉल्ड कैटिनेशन प्रॉपर्टी ड्यू टू विच दे गेट्स कंबाइन टू ईच अदर. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट यू डू जस्ट फॉर्म द बॉन्ड बिटवीन कार्बन कार्बन. फर्स्ट दो है कार्बन तो कार्बन कार्बन. Then each carbon needs four bond. Each carbon needs four bond. Okay, so just draw the bond. So between carbon, carbon is a one bond. Now this bond here with hydrogen H, H, H here, H, H, H. So just see, this becomes the structure of CH3, CH3. Just see, each carbon has got four bond. You can, if you just look at this, this carbon has got four bond. One bond, two bond, three bond, four bond. Same here. One bond, two, three, four. So this way we can draw the bond structure here. For practice, you just draw the bond structure of this. Third example, I'm just writing CH2, CH3. Complete its bond structure, all of you. Then complete this. complete the bond structure for both. Samyak, कहाँ गए? So here, if I just quickly draw this, so carbon, and there is this one, same here. Here also C, C, C. Every carbon, just C, has got four bond. Just see, each carbon has got four bond completed here. Okay. Now try this then. One next example is CH2, CH2. Try this, everybody. CH2, CH2. And then CH, CH. Done. So here you can see carbon. पहले तो carbon carbon draw कर दो. इसके साथ H2CH2 दिया है तो दो hydrogen इसके साथ attach है. इसके साथ भी दो hydrogen. इसके बाद भी देखो carbon का चार bond complete नहीं हुआ है. So in that case what we do, we draw one more bond between carbon carbon. It is double bond. It is called double bond. So there is between carbon carbon there is a double bond because carbon always will have a four bonds. Carbon always will have a four bonds. Just for your basic information here, between two atoms. Always the first bond is sigma bond. Sigma is the name that we will come to learn in chemical bonding chapter. So like here between two atoms, jaise abhi dekho between carbon and hydrogen, it is a one bond. So one bond is always, the first bond is always a sigma bond. Sigma we write like this, just see, it is a sigma. Sigma bond. Sigma bond means the first bond between the two atoms is always a sigma bond. So, dekho, between carbon and hydrogen, there is only one bond, it is sigma. Between carbon and hydrogen, there is only one bond, it is also sigma. If you just see here, between carbon and carbon, here, we have two bonds. तो अगर दो एटम के बीच में दो सेम या डिफरेंट एटम के बीच में अगर दो या दो से अधिक बॉन्ड हो सो वी कॉल दैट इज अ मल्टीपल बॉन्ड. मल्टीपल बॉन्ड में फर्स्ट बॉन्ड विल बी ऑलवेज सिग्मा. एक ही बॉन्ड उसमें सिग्मा होता है. रिमेनिंग बॉन्ड इज कॉल्ड पाई बॉन्ड. वी राइट लाइक दिस. दिस इज सिग्मा bond and this is pi bond. Just see pi सबने पाई आर स्क्वायर, टू पाई आर सबने किया होगा, वही यही है। बिटवीन टू एटम्स ओनली वन बॉन्ड विल बी सिग्मा, रिमेनिंग बॉन्ड्स विल बी पाई बॉन्ड। बिटवीन टू एटम्स ओनली वन बॉन्ड विल बी सिग्मा, रिमेनिंग बॉन्ड विल बी पाई बॉन्ड। तो अगर एक ही बॉन्ड है तो दैट बॉन्ड विल बी ऑलवेज अ सिग्मा बॉन्ड ओनली। अभी देखो, नाउ बिटवीन सी एंड एच देयर इज ओनली वन बॉन्ड, सो दिस विल बी सिग्मा। हियर बिटवीन सी एंड एच ओनली वन बॉन्ड, सो दिस इज सिग्मा। सो इफ आई आस्क यू इन CH2CH2 हाउ मेनी सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स आर देयर, इन CH2CH2 द नंबर ऑफ सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स कितने होंगे? वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव, जस्ट सी, फाइव सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स एंड नंबर ऑफ पाई बॉन्ड्स ओनली वन। तो ऐसे भी क्वेश्चंस होते हैं, देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ दीज काइंड्स आल्सो। रिमेंबर, अगर मल्टीपल बॉन्ड है तो ओनली फर्स्ट बॉन्ड विल बी सिग्मा, रिमेनिंग बॉन्ड्स विल बी पाई बॉन्ड। ओके, ऑलवेज। हाँ, ये हाउ इट कम्स दैट विल कम टू नो इन केमिकल बॉन्डिंग चैप्टर इन 11th स्टैंडर्ड। राइट नाउ वी हैव टू नो द नेम्स सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड पाई बॉन्ड। ओके, नाउ ड्रॉ द बॉन्ड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस CH-CH। Similarly, draw this and find the number of sigma bond, number of pi bond. Do it. So structure is this sigma bond. So between how many sigma bond, Samyak? थ्री सिग्मा टू पाई, जस्ट सी बिटवीन कार्बन कार्बन सिग्मा इज ऑल्सो सिग्मा। थ्री बॉन्ड आउट ऑफ थ्री ओनली वन बॉन्ड विल बी सिग्मा, रिमेनिंग विल बी पाई बॉन्ड। दिस इज सिग्मा, दिस इज पाई, दिस इज पाई। इन मल्टीपल बॉन्ड ओनली वन बॉन्ड इज सिग्मा, रिमेनिंग बॉन्ड्स आर पाई बॉन्ड इन मल्टीपल बॉन्ड सिस्टम। Okay, in this structure all bonds are sigma bond. Here in these structures all bonds are sigma bond. Okay, now I'll give you question here. Question is, write a question, find out the number of sigma and pi bonds in the following compounds. Find out number of sigma and pi bonds in the following compound. So question is given. देखो ये फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, CH3, I think handwriting is okay. And the fifth is last one. What basic rule you have to follow? Carbon needs 4 bond, nitrogen needs 3 bond, oxygen needs 2 bond. So that is the basic. CH bond is always a sigma bond. यहाँ पे देखो इन सारे एग्जाम्पल में CH bond is always a sigma bond. Multiple bond comes between CC, CN, CO because hydrogen needs only one bond. So bond with hydrogen will be always a sigma bond. Well, I think first में all bonds are sigma bond. तो first case में sigma bond how many sigma bonds? Yes. 13. Yes, 13. करेक्ट जाए पाई बॉन्ड इज जीरो देखो तो सम्यक ठीक है 13 ईशा
यस सर
नेक्स्ट आल्सो हियर जस्ट हियर आल्सो यू कैन सी ऑल बॉन्ड्स आर सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स हियर बिकॉज बिटवीन कार्बन कार्बन देयर इज नो मल्टीपल बॉन्ड सी एच थ्री यस बताओ फिर हाउ मेनी सिग्मा थर्ड में यस 22 करेक्ट पाई बॉन्ड इज जीरो Second, yes. Twelve sigma pi bond two. I think दिख रहा है दो pi bond यहाँ पे multiple bond यहाँ पे one sigma one pi यहाँ भी multiple bond है one sigma one pi. So you will have 12 sigma and pi bond will be two. Correct. यहाँ पे सिग्मा एंड पाई फर्स्ट टेल मी पाई बॉन्ड तो हियर तो यस तो पाई बॉन्ड इज 5 हाउ मेनी सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स
7
Sigma bond, if you just see here there is again you can see this carbon again यहाँ पे जो corner points है ना these corner points are carbon ये होता है it is called line structure में corner points are carbon So if I draw it separately here, just see. So here the just see corner points are ये यहाँ पे carbon है, यहाँ पे carbon, ये carbon, देखो ये, it is like this. These are carbon. Carbon needs how many bond? Carbon needs 4 bond. देखो, just if you see for this carbon, you can see 1, 2, 3 bonds. Where is 4th bond? For this carbon, where is the 4th bond? So 4th bond is hidden. 4th bond is with hydrogen. That is invisible bond. Here also for this carbon, I can see 1, 2, 3. 4th bond is hydrogen. Same here, hydrogen. Let's see. 4th bond is hydrogen because carbon needs 4 bond. And here you can see only 3 bonds. For this carbon, you can see only 3 bonds. So 1, 2, 3. So remaining bond is with hydrogen. So now you tell me the number of sigma bond and pi bond. Yes, so pi bond to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pi bond utna hi rahega, 5. Pi bond will not change. The sigma bond will change now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 6 here. 6 or 5, 11, 12, 13, 14. Let's see. 14 sigma bonds. Okay, sabko. Dekhna to. The last question, this one. C2, CN, 4. Iska matlab kya hai ki CN is 4 times. और C2 कार्बन इज 2 टाइम्स. तो तुमको पहले इसका स्ट्रक्चर ड्रॉ करना होगा. हाउ? बाय कीपिंग इन माइंड द नंबर ऑफ बॉन्ड्स. कार्बन नीड्स 4 बॉन्ड, नाइट्रोजन नीड्स 3 बॉन्ड. कार्बन नीड्स 4 बॉन्ड, नाइट्रोजन नीड्स 3 बॉन्ड. कीपिंग दैट आइडिया इन माइंड, यू कैन draw the structure of C2CN4. तन्मय, सम्यक, गार्गी, what happened? Just it's a 1 hour class. उसमें तो वीडियो ऑन रखो. सम्यक भाग गया शायद. सम्यक भाग गए. गार्गी, keep the video on. सम्यक कहाँ भाग गए थे? ठीक है, वीडियो ऑन रखो. हाँ, यस. सो ड्रॉ द स्ट्रक्चर फर्स्ट, देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू काउंट द नंबर ऑफ सिग्मा बॉन्ड और पाई बॉन्ड. how to draw structure, keeping in mind carbon needs 4 bond, nitrogen needs 3 bond. And that's why we have written this. जो टेबल मैंने लिख के दिया इसीलिए दिया. हाँ डन जॉय ईशा डन टेल मी ईशा हाउ मेनी सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स.
9
एंड पाई बॉन्ड
8. सर गारंटी नहीं यहाँ पर.
हाँ एक शायद कम हो गया. देखो यहाँ पे तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ड्रॉ द स्ट्रक्चर. C2 मींस व्हाट कि दोनों कार्बन एक दूसरे से अटैच है. देखो मैंने ड्रॉ किया CC, ठीक है. और CN मींस व्हाट कि ये अगर स्ट्रक्चर ऐसा है तो 2 CN टू ईच कार्बन. इसके साथ CN, इसके साथ CN, फिर वैसे ही CN, फिर वैसे ही यहाँ पे CN. अभी देखो यहाँ पे तुमको स्ट्रक्चर कंप्लीट करना है तो कार्बन नीड्स नाइट्रोजन नीड्स 3 बॉन्ड तो 1 2 3 बिकॉज यहाँ पे हाइड्रोजन है ही नहीं तो यही होगा. नाइट्रोजन नीड्स 3 बॉन्ड 1 2 3 नाइट्रोजन इज 3 बॉन्ड 1 2 3 नाइट्रोजन नीड्स 3 बॉन्ड 1 2 3 ठीक है. And now just see this carbon just 3 bond is complete. We need 4 bond. So one more bond is with this. So now see all carbon, all 4 bonds are complete. Nitrogen 3 bonds are complete, which is requirement for the bond formation. Okay, so structure you have to draw like this if it is given. Yes, so how many sigma? Sigma and pi. आई होप अभी आ जाएगा. 2, 4, 6, 8 और 9. पाई इज 9 बॉन्ड्स यस एंड सिग्मा इज 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 बोथ आर करेक्ट. तन्मय so first bond between two atoms is always a sigma bond. The remaining bond is pi bond. Okay. Clear, everybody? So this is all about. In next class, we'll start the bond line structure for organic chemistry. ये जो स्ट्रक्चर मैंने ड्रॉ किया था इट इज कॉल्ड बॉन्ड लाइन स्ट्रक्चर. ओके सो दिस स्ट्रक्चर वी लर्न इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास देन वी विल बी इन पोजीशन टू स्टार्ट विद द क्लासिफिकेशन एंड नोमेनक्लेचर. ओके सो विल स्टॉप हियर. एनी डाउट इफ यू हैव जस्ट सी एनी डाउट इफ यू हैव. No doubt. ठीक है then. So on Monday 2 o'clock you will have a maths. Okay. So be there on Monday. Okay. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 1, 2 to 3 only, and we will try to not give homework because your board preparation is also going on, but we'll try. Okay. So it's a 1 hour, 3 days a week. Okay. So should we stop here?